but they were engineered well, and generally speaking, they can easily last 200 plus thousand miles with proper maintenance. I have a 1992 Mazda Miata with the 1.6 liter engine and about 204,000 miles on it. And I just recently took that on a 2-day, 24 hour road trip all the way from Denver, Colorado to South Carolina. My Miata guzzes quite a bit of oil and definitely has a little bit of rod knock or something going on, but she made it there with no problems along the way. That really shouldn't be that surprising because the 1.6 liter engines in the NA Miata from 1990 to 1993 are nearly bulletproof. These engines are extremely strong, but that doesn't mean that they don't come with a few flaws and common problems. First, before we go ahead and jump into those problems, just as I mentioned in terms of the overall reliability, these engines are extremely strong. Of course, they only come with 116 horsepower, so there's not too much that can go wrong from a power standpoint, but they were engineered well, and generally speaking, they can easily last 200 plus thousand miles with proper maintenance. When it comes to problems that arise on these, most of them tend to just be from normal age now that all of these engines are 30 plus years old. While there are a decent number of problems that arise, Miatas are extremely easy to work on. The parts are usually very cheap, and they're great cars to learn to work on. One of the most common things is going to be oil leaks, specifically from two common places. The first most common one is going to be from the CAS, or the camshaft angle sensor. And then the second one's gonna be from the valve cover gasket. Of course, this is primarily driven by engine age and mileage, but it is more so a question of when you're gonna have oil leaks coming from the CAS and the valve cover gasket rather than if. So they are very inexpensive and easy to fix, but there are two things that you're definitely gonna come across if you own one of these. Second on our list is gonna be issues with the cooling system. The radiators on these NA Miatas are notoriously unreliable. They're made of plastic, and so the plastic components on the radiator tend to crack over time, and that causes radiator leaks and ultimately leads to the engine overheating. While there aren't very many things that can kill a 1.6 liter, overheating is. So making sure your cooling system is functioning properly is extremely important. In addition to the radiator, just because of engine age, it is common to have issues with your hoses becoming brittle and experiencing coolant leaks coming from coolant hoses and things like that. But the radiator is the most prone to failing and cracking and leaking. Third on our list is going to be the timing belt and the water pump. The 1.6 liter engine is not an interference engine. And so when you run into issues with the timing belt, even if the timing belt snaps, you're generally not looking at catastrophic engine damage, but it is going to make your car down for the count until you get it fixed. And typically it's recommended to replace the water pump whenever you're replacing the timing belt, just because the water pumps are known to fail as well, especially as these engines age. Fourth on our list is going to be issues with the ignition system. The coil packs and the spark plug wires do tend to go bad relatively frequently. And on the older distributor styles, the caps or rotors are known to fail on those as well. And this ultimately leads to rough idling, misfires, and other ignition system related problems and symptoms. Fifth on our list, which is probably more common than the order that I've put it in, is going to be issues with the idle air control valve. I actually have this going on with my Miata right now. If you have any issues where you turn your air conditioning on and your idles drop or your engine completely stalls out, you could be having an issue with the idle air control valve. That is essentially what controls how much air is entering the engine when the engine is idling. And that can lead to a number of issues with your engine stalling out, RPMs being super high or super low, getting a lot of variation in RPMs. The idle air control valve is one component on these cars that actually is wildly expensive. I think a new idle air control valve, even a refurbished one for these 1.6 liters, is something like $600 or $700. And so generally the best thing to do is to go ahead and pull it off, try to clean it, and most of the time that fixes it. Six on our list is gonna be issues with the clutch master and slave cylinder. Those are known to go bad from time to time. And a lot of times you might think that you just have wear and tear going with your clutch and that you need to replace the clutch, but a lot of times it's just the slave or master cylinder. And then Seventh on our list here is gonna be excessive oil consumption. This is definitely something that my Miata struggles with, and that's because it doesn't quite have the strongest motor on it at 204,000 miles. There's definitely some wear and tear going on the internals, and most commonly you see issues with the valve stem seals, and that leads to extreme or excessive oil consumption. On my road trip across country, I was putting like a quart of oil in for every like 250 miles that I was going, so the oil consumption issues are pretty excessive on it. But the crazy thing is it doesn't leak oil anywhere, it just consumes it at a very high rate. So this is something that tends to happen as these engines get to higher mileage and you start to run into issues with the valve stem seals and other internal components. So that's really it to cover on common problems for the 1.6 liter and the Mazda Miata. These engines, like I mentioned, are extremely reliable. There's not a whole lot on them that can lead to catastrophic engine failure, except for overheating, which is why it's important to make sure you're taking care of your cooling system. Outside of that, these engines are 30 plus years old, and so you're gonna have water pump failure, you're gonna have coolant system leaks, you're gonna have oil leaks, and a number of other maintenance related problems like your ignition system, so on and so forth. So like I mentioned earlier, these engines are extremely easy to work on. They're extremely cheap from a maintenance standpoint, and so it makes them really fun cars to own and really fun cars to learn to work on, and that's why I love mine. Anyways guys, that covers it for our video on common problems on the Mazda Miata 1.6 liter. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned as I'll have a bunch more Miata content that I'll continue to film in the coming months.